For, I don't know, I mean, for TUP and for STI. Yeah, for STI here, we have an Orianna, Varus, and Ahri, so more target advance in the mid lane.
Oh, mid lane. Yeah, mid lane bans. Their mid laner is Ashley.
Yeah, Ashley. Wow. And Ashley is actually a competitor in the ISL.
Solarity.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, that's great. So here we have very, very common first picks dito. Like the Nautilus, the Rek'Sai, the Gragas, and the Hecarim. Wow!
Yeah.
Talagang hindi siya unorthodox actually.
Yes,
parang
yes.
Pro na picks.
Yeah,
no?
Standard picks. No? I like the priority that TUP gave to Gragas kasi Gragas is really the god tier jungler right now with the nerf to Sejuani with the Flail of the Northern Winds scaling. Talagang nag-suffer yung damage output niya.
Yeah.
And hindi na siya ganun kalakas mag-scale. Pero still formidable jungler. It's just that mas pinaprioritize na ngayon si Gragas and Rek'Sai as well in the jungler.
Actually,
in the jungle, I mean.
May nagtanong sa akin kanina kung bukas na daw si Echo.
Yeah,
it's open na kasi pro gaming series. Diba?
Yeah.
Is already using Echo as well.
Ang rules natin kasi, once a champion gets a major rework or a new champion is released, immediately auto-ban siya for the next 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yes.
Okay.
So, Echo was released, I think, 3 to 4 weeks ago. So, playable na siya ngayon sa PGS and ang ating LCL. So, yeah, we have also, yun nga, nabanggit mo yung priority pick kay Nautilus plus kay Rek'Sai. Rek'Sai being a top-tier jungler in this patch as well. And Nautilus being an astonishing support.
Yes.
With the tankiness, with the CC that he brings. And, basically an all-around support for Nautilus. Great for tanking and peeling for your AD carry.
Actually nga, Professor, naisip ko baka kinuha nila yung Nautilus kasi kukuha nila si Vayne, diba?
Yeah, probably. Kasi you need extra peel for Vayne. This is either
Janna,
Nami, and Nautilus actually. So, meron kang cover for Vayne. So, Vayne can freely kite in the backlines without getting hammered down.
Yes. never gets old.
Yeah. And I also like the pickup, the second pick order for TUP. No, they have the Alistar and the Hecarim.
Yeah.
Hecarim top, being a meta top laner right
with
now.
Smite.
Yeah, with the Smite or Ignite actually.
Smite or Ignite.
Yeah, if you're going for the Smite, then you know you're going for a Cinderhulk, more tanky approach to Hecarim.
Nice.
Yeah, so you go for a Skirmisher Saber, then a Cinderhulk upgrade to buff the tankiness of Hecarim. Because Hecarim initially isn't really that tanky early game.
Yeah.
You need the items for him to be, you know, super tanky
effective
as well. Lalo na he needs to dive with the Onslaught of Shadows.
Yeah, yun pa, di ba?
Yeah.
Napaka all-in ni Hecarim.
Actually,
I wanted to ask you, Professor. Mm. Aside from yung mga top laners, smiters natin, wait, nagpalit siya ng spell. Cleanse and yung pang mana?
Clarity.
Okay.
Okay, we'll see. It's not yet done.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. So we still have some time.
Oops. So anyway, Professor, back to my question.
Yeah.
Aside from Hecarim, aside from champions sa top lane na gumagamit ng smite, sino pa kaya ang i-recommend mo aside from Hecarim na pwedeng gumamit ng smite tactic dito sa top lane?
Actually, I highly recommend Fizz and Shen, actually.
Shen?
Yeah, Shen. Shiva, actually, originally, the Smite top originated in around Korea or China. I think it's China.
Mm-hmm.
Then Korea adapted to it quickly. And it was originally intended for Shyvana. Kasi Shyvana really is a very mobile champion with the W, the Burnout.
Ah, yes.
Yeah, so true. Increased movement speed plus yung kanyang ultimate which can function as a low cooldown flash.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, with the damage then, diba? Mm. So, ang only downside, actually I watched a few videos regarding the Smite top meta, and the only downside that of the Smite teleport summoner spell is that you don't run flash. That's the only downside to it. And you gain everything. You gain the ability to get the
Skirmisher Saber.
Yeah, and the Cinderhulk upgrade, so super tanky top laner, plus mas malakas yung objective control nyo having two smites in your team.
Yes, that's
so
true.
Yeah, so that's the only downsides to having a smite teleport.
You're really not safe sa lane.
Yeah. Well, for Hecarim naman, you have the E ability, you know, the devastating charge, I think. And with that, you can easily escape yung mga skills
ganks,
or ganks ng opposing jungler and the laner. So, I really like the pickup of Alistar. No? Alistar being a top-tier support right now in the meta as well. So, nauso ngayon yung mga super tanky na support.
Oh, yun nga eh.
With Nautilus, with the, you know,
pero
Alistar.
Pero still, Janna is still...
Janna is still viable, super viable right now. With the peel and the, you know, the safety that she gives dun sa yung AD carry.
AD carry. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ang medyo nawala no yung parang si Nanami.
Yeah, diba? Yeah. They kind of fell off kasi you know, there are much better picks than them. And yeah, actually TUP picking up a Kale. I think Kale would be going mid. We haven't actually seen Kale in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, with the I think Kale fell off when they nerfed the damage of the Q.
The Q, not the E.
Kasi the E is just like the staple for Kale. Mm-hmm. And the Q, they decreased the damage output. Kasi sobrang lakas talaga nung
Q
before.
Well, actually, medyo may pagka-bursty siya around mid-ish.
Yeah. Mid-Q. And sobra kasing, ano, sobrang laki natutulong nung Q kapag nagsaspam ka ng E.
Yeah, tapos attack speed.
Yeah, the stacks as well. Sobrang burned na burned yung ano mo, magic resistant armor mo, which is like, yung damage output coming from Kale is mixed damage primarily. Pero prioritization pa rin ng AP.
Yeah, I'm actually a Kale player before. So medyo may special place siya sa puso ko si Kale.
So yun, narinig yun, guys.
May drama.
GS Riku has a special place in her heart for Kale.
For Kale, yes, that's true.
Yeah. And,
top lane.
Top lane as well. You know, so I was talking about the top lane, we have STI Fizz. Fizz top. So yung nakita natin kahapon sa game ng PGS, no? Fizz was actually used to counter the Jarvan up top.
Yeah, yung mga split pusher para makikipag-duel siya.
Yeah. Well, actually, countering a split pusher can go about can go into two ways. Now, one, you pick up a duelist, a really good duelist like Fizz, which was what Centaur did.
Yes.
And second, you pick a champion that has a faster wave clear.
Oh, yeah.
So you outpush that guy.
That guy.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, so they have a Fizz in the top side, while in the mid, they have a Cho'Gath.
Yeah.
Which is, I think Kale is going to have a problem with Cho'Gath. Lalo na Cho'Gath has that 2.25 second silence with a level 5 Feral Scream. Yeah. And Kale needs that time to activate intervention. If ever, if ever Kaito lands a good Feral Scream and a Ravage, is it, ano, the Rupture plus a Feral Scream at the right time, then mami-mitigate yung advantage na binibigay ni Alesso sa team fights with you know, the ultimate kasi he needs to cast it at the at a precise moment.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so to prevent damages to you know any of the members of their team.
Yes.
And if that Feral Scream hits Kale, then you know it's gonna
be
cast. Horrible.
Yeah,
for
as in kasi very crucial pa minsan yung Kale ultimate kasi there are times that you have to use it sa simula pa lang. Para, kasi people sometimes tend to change skills. They stop. Tapos, there are times naman na dapat ginagamit mo at the last second.
Yeah, exactly.
So, it's kind of, actually, hindi ko pa napapractice yung the first type. I keep on using the clutch interventions. So, as to they tend to overcommit to that single target na malapit nang mamatay.
Yeah. And actually, yung intervention, yun nga, di ba sinabi mo may two types kung paano gamitin yung intervention. One is yung you use it immediately kapag nakita mo nag-cast na ng mga parang FF or nag-cast na sila ng CC spells nila dun sa isa sa mga primary targets sa team nyo. And another one is the clutch intervention.
Yes.
And I'm not saying na one is better than the other. It just depends on the situation then. So, you know, you can use the intervention early on just to prevent you from getting a positional disadvantage. And the second one is more of a clutch play, which, you know, a saving play.
Yes.
And can also turn around the fight. Diba? If they're gonna like leave a person from the TUP team to die with an ignite or something.
Yeah,
then, you know, intervention, then they're not expecting, why didn't he die? And then he comes back to, you know,
try to kill
someone. So something like that.
Yeah, you're right.
That could work.
Yeah. We will see those kinds of plays later on. And right now, you are watching once again the LoL Collegiate League 2015 summer term. It is game one between TUP versus STI. Yung name nila nga ulit ng team name nila ulit.
TUP is the Greyhawks Esports.
Greyhawk Esports and STI is the
Kingdom Sports Hub.
Kingdom Sports Hub. Yes. KSH.
Yes.
We'll see though. Sa tingin mo, Professor, alin yung level 1 na malakas dito sa teams natin?
I think KSH has an advantage level 1. Kasi just because of the dredge line plus the rupture coming from Cho'Gath, mas meron silang edge in terms of like CC out dito. And looks like no, KSH actually grouping up and planning, intending to take this bottom side. However, they get spotted. And Akeno-san actually missing a dredge line right there, which prompts them to go back to their own side of the jungle. And just Riku, can you break us down the TUP lineup?
Oh yes, for the blue side we have TUP in the top lane. We have that's the jungler. We have Rey, Chanel on the Gragas. For the top lane we have Cookie with a Hecarim, and for the support we have Rhea Cutie on the Alistar support, Aqualux and with the AD carry Graves, and Alesso in the mid lane with a Kayle.
And for the red side, we have STI, Kingdom Sports Sub. In the top side, we have Unavailable with that Fizz. In the jungle, we have Leo with that Rek'Sai. In the mid lane, we have Kaito with that Cho'Gath. And in the bottom side, we have Ashley and Akeno-san with a duo Nautilus and Vayne.
Akeno-san. Help but say it in a Japanese way. Exactly.
Yes.
With the sun and all.
Yeah, and looking at the TUP side of the map, looks like the Hecarim would be going for a level 2 start, which actually is very beneficial for him in the top lane, lalo na Fizz yung katapad niya. He'll need that extra experience to stay afloat in lane.
And pero pagdating sa lane matchups, sino mas lamang, Hecarim or the Fizz?
Well, if it's like long term, if Fizz won't trade immediately, like hindi siya magiging super aggressive sa lane, Hecarim can actually, you know, pachepi-chepi lang ng Q. Okay. Yeah. Like harass with the Q. But then if KSH unavailable, would be dueling Hecarim. But I don't think he would duel him pre-level 3 or 4. Kasi he'll need all his skills to be really effective in trading. So I think Hecarim before level 3, level 4. But then come level 5.
Wow.
I think Fizz can actually out-trade Hecarim here.
Pero di ba may sustain naman si Hecarim, so I guess we're slightly fine.
Yeah, and it looks like an early engage here. A flash coming from Rey, Chanel. Kaito forced to flash out, but that would be a first blood in favor of TUP.
Wow, Professor.
I didn't know I had that in me.
Yeah. Well, now you know, Professor. Great job.
Thank you.
So, yeah, that was a great early gank coming in from the ground. They took advantage of how immobile Cho'Gath was. So, that earned first blood for TUP.
Yeah, actually. Wow. Good job, student. You're now learning. You're learning the ropes of the LoL.
Yes,
of
I've
Legends,
learned
huh?
from the best. Okay, anyway, let's move on.
Yeah, so that was actually a very good gank coming from TUP, no? Rey, Chanel actually flashing in with the body slam and capitalizing, as you said, you know, the immobility of Cho'Gath. And that makes the mid lane pressure greater to Kaito right now. Kasi even though Alesso burned the flash as well. Yeah, so I think both mid laners now, you know, has increased pressure on them. Kasi with that, they don't have flash, and both doesn't really have a reliable escape mech.
Yes.
So
pero medyo mas safe pa si Kayle, no, kasi yung W niya yung medyo heal with the movement speed.
Yeah.
As long as siguro meron ward dito si Kayle dito sa mid lane. Wow. Cookie taking turrets.
Wow.
Right there. And here comes Unavailable dropping down the ignite on the horse.
Yeah, but that ignite was a bit too early.
Really?
Yeah. And he didn't have actually the urgent strike to follow it up. I think he just used it. That's why it was on cooldown. And if actually he had the urgent strike, it might be a kill. It might have been a kill to Cookie. And masyado pa mahina yung ano niya, yung sea stone trident niya at this point of the game.
Yeah.
With only I think 1 or 2 points back then when the trade happened. So you know the ignite burned for unavailable here, alleviating the pressure to Hecarim by quite a bit.
Yeah. I did a Fizz player.
Yeah, I used to actually. Before, actually. This is one of the fun fact. Actually, not a fun fact. Maybe a fact.
Okay, we'll see.
Before the rework to Fizz, the slight rework to Fizz, but they changed the mechanic of the ultimate and the Sea Stone Trident.
Yes.
And actually, before that happened, I was trying to make Jungle Fizz viable. Like, I knew that. I know that Jungle Fizz is viable.
Yeah.
Somewhere, there's a way to make him viable. And I kept on playing Jungle Fizz that time. Like, dude, this is gonna work.
This was in season 4.
Pre-season 5.
Pre-season 5. So, meron ng mga different smites already.
Yes, meron ng different smites. And I was really having a hard time because the damage of Sea Stone Trident back then was not really that much, I guess, if you don't build. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure what the most usual comments yung comments na talagang madalas sa akin regarding my Fizz, Jungle Fizz, is that I don't deal that much damage. I'm super tanky kasi that's like how I build jungle phase, like Sunfire Cape, Randuin's or Frozen Heart before.
Yes.
And yun yung usual na binibuild ko sa kanya. Tapos, you know, I don't deal much damage. I'm just relying on the percentage DPS coming from the Seastone Trident. But then I don't build AP. I build AD.
Oh,
so,
AD Fizz.
AD Fizz. So I don't deal much. Uh-huh. Pero right now, I think it's more viable because yung ultimate niya, which grants the Fizz, it grants Fizz the additional damage. Regardless of being it being magical or physical damage.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so increased 20% damage, I think. So it's either it can either go physical or magic. So ano siya? So
parang
you can build
matter.
It doesn't matter, and mas maganda na mag-build ng AD Fizz ngayon kasi meron na siyang
multiplier.
Multiplier din sa ultimate. And
wow.
That makes it better right now building kaya nauso yung jungle and top Fizz na AD.
Ah, I see.
Yeah.
So, and what smite do you usually wear?
Skirmishers to amplify the Seastone Trident.
Skirmishers the red.
Yeah, the red one. Kasi you know, if you hit someone with the Seastone Trident and you burn them with the Skirmisher Saber, it's true damage plus the DPS coming from the Skirmisher Saber.
Oh, right.
I mean, true damage coming from the Skirmisher Saber and the magic damage coming from the Seastone Trident.
Ah, okay, I see. Kaya pala.
Yeah.
So, I'm also thinking kung ano pa yung mga pwedeng gawin sa top lane na smite with the Skirmishers.
Yeah.
Na that has also yung parang amplifying damage rin sa kit nila.
Yeah.
Parang it would fit. Kasi parang konti lang nga, di ba? Iilan lang. Tatlo lang yata. We can only name like three champions that uses that, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Yung Smite top.
Mm-hmm.
So I kinda wanna.
But yeah, I think Smite top is actually quite flexible.
Mm-hmm.
You just need a champion that has, you
know, consistent damage.
Yeah, consistent damage plus a mobility skill.
Kasi,
you know, yun nga yung downside niya is having no flash.
Oh yeah.
So you need this a safe escape mechanism for you to be able to utilize it well.
Mm-hmm.
Yun. Okay. So yun nga, Shyvana, Fizz actually has a, di ba?
Yung
kanyang playful
trickster,
or trickster. So yun, pwede sa kanya use Skirmisher Saber and he greatly benefits from it. Kasi it actually grants, kunyari, may Vayne. And it actually grants you vision of your target.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, for 6 seconds. Tapos may burn pa. Tapos you actually take 20% less damage dun sa target na nasmite mo. Yeah, so pang zoning talaga siya. Great for champions like Poppy actually, Poppy. Poppy is one of the champions na pwede mong gamitan nun. Pero Poppy is not really that mobile of a champion.
Yeah.
Wala siyang decent escape, sure na escape mechanism.
Yeah, that's
so I don't recommend building a
Poppy,
you know, Poppy
dun
with a
top lane.
Yeah, unless you're gonna go for jungle Poppy and you go Smite Ghost.
Yeah, I saw you do that.
Yeah, I actually main Poppy then before.
Oh,
yeah, jungle Poppy. Yeah, and Poppy is actually a good jungler. It's just that medyo mabagal yung clear speed mo. Plus, if you don't build Triforce immediately, pag hindi mo nakuha yung Triforce agad, that drastically decreases your damage output.
Oh, I see. Tsaka parang medyo mahirap siya makipag-gank, no? Lalo na kung yung mga lanes mo wala masyadong hard CC, no?
Yeah. But then, you know, you need to just time your heroic charge. Kaya kailangan tumama siya sa wall kasi may stun siya. Displacement plus stun pag tumama siya sa wall. Something, it works like Vayne's Condemn.
Oh,
so, you just need to hit that and it would result to a kill if your mid laner would respond to that one.
Sakit-sakit nga ni Poppy. Napansin.
Yeah, and hindi siya ini-expect. Di ba yung Poppy ni TG? Yeah, so I think,
the backlines.
The backlines. Yeah, you need to dive in the backlines. Tapos, you know, you use your ultimate kay dun sa AD carry ng kalabas. You won't get CC'd.
Yes.
And you know, just run towards the AD carry and hammer him down.
I love that hammering down. Anyway, yung ultimate ni Poppy, medyo I understand it, pero not actually very good. Na normally I see people use the ultimate dun sa pinakamahina.
Yeah, it depends. It depends on the usage.
Your playstyle.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it. So right now we can see the two top laners, actually two junglers rotating at the top. Magkakabungguan sila Ray, Chanel, and Leo will get knocked up. Itulak lang siya. Unavailable will dash in to the Gragas and he will eat the shark. At dito si Cookie for the backup, but he is just too painful itong dalawa, si Rek'Sai and si Fizz. But Unavailable gets ignited. That will be a revenge kill for both of them. Leo super low right now. Will go tunnel.
Oh.
And the onslaught of shadows right there will probably not secure the kill.
Yeah, he flashed. He flashed.
Yeah, I flashed.
Okay. He tunneled and then he flashed away towards dun sa ledge dun sa Baron.
So that's one. Oh wow, Alesso, really, really low.
Yeah, kanina no, nung early game, nung before pre-level 6, haras na haras si Kaito with Alesso. And I think Alesso did a really good job in preventing Kaito from gaining experience, though, zoning him away from the minion so that he won't get experience. And right now, there's a 2-level advantage in from Alesso and Kaito plus a 20, almost 20 minion kill score lead dito kay Alesso. So aside from the fact na kill si Alesso, si Kaito early game, na manage din ni Alesso na i-maximize yung lead na yon, mag-snowball from there to prevent Kaito from farming. And you know, his experience gain was reduced drastically. Kasi diba, if you're a mid laner, you would want to like get in the level of the opposite mid laner or lumamang. And yun yung ginawa ni Alesso dito. Lumamang siya in terms of experience sa sobra kay Kaito. Kaya nagsasuffer ngayon si Kaito. And you can't blame Kaito kasi the early game harass coming from Kale is really, really difficult to deal with.
Yeah, ang ganda ng range pa naman kasi ni Kale eh. Madali po, mag-iika lang tapos isu-zone mo. Here we see Leo though. Hovering dito, walang vision, they have no idea, meron Rek'Sai na nakatago doon. Very great. Not scrying. That's
They saw the... I think.
The snout.
Yeah, I think they saw the scrying. Yeah, they saw the scrying.
Yeah, medyo halata no kung ganun.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, it's not scrying, it's the...
Oh yeah, yeah, the...
The red trinket, yeah, the red trinket.
The upgrade is called Oracle's Lens. Oh, Sweeping Lens, Sweeping Lens, yeah.
Okay.
That's why it's Scrying.
I was like,
it's S. So, it's S.
Wait, Scrying is S.
Yeah, yeah, that's why I was like, Scrying. No, it's Sweeping.
Yeah, I remember yun nga yung joke ni Freak, diba? Scrying is like crying. Kasi naspatan mo yung...
Word.
Kunwari nagka-cup sila dun sa brush ng 5-man. That's not spot, so they're crying.
Oh, yeah. It's crying.
It's crying. Yeah. And it's blue, so tears.
Wow.
5 tier. I master, champion mastery, level 5.
Oh, Aqualux actually dealing out some damage here.
Ooh, nice sidestep by Alesso, but here comes Leo for the gank. He will get knocked off probably. And right here, Ray Chanel actually is there for the backup. Teleport will come up from top. They get knocked up. Kaito
nice.
To eat the kale right now, and here comes Cookie. Also out of shadow, he eats the shark as well. Chanel is hesitating at the moment.
Oh no!
Yes, to try and do something. Flashes out. That is a 2-0 in favor of SDI.
Yeah, that was just I thought Leo could have knocked up Alesso earlier.
Yeah.
He was in range of the unburrow at the knock up, but then I don't know what happened. Maybe he really wants to get underneath the Kale just to be sure, maybe.
I don't know
what happened there, but you know, it resulted for a two kills for the SEI there, and they would be taking Dragon right now. Ray Chanel actually posing to take this one, however, that was a bit too late. I'm not sure what the goal of that explosive gask was, but that was, if the goal was to disengage or maybe steal the Dragon, that was a bit too late.
Yes, super.
And the collateral damage as well.
So two ultimates.
I don't know. Maybe they were trying to coordinate their skills. If they actually managed to hit Leo, I think they could have taken him down then.
Yeah. Look at that. Pushing. Actually, ang ganda ng pag fast pusher din tong ano eh, Kale.
Yeah, you have good wave clear. You have also good turret sieging because you have a fast attack speed.
Yep.
And you have AoE damage. And it's gonna be hell now for Alesso.
Wow, intervention used here just for the flash, just to negate the damage, but she still stays.
Oh, she's still there.
Oh, she still stays. No more flash. Probably trying to bait something, but that was really awkward to watch. Andun sana si Chanel, but ang layo for the backup. I don't know what they were trying to do there.
This is actually good prioritization coming from Alesso, ganking the middle lane, knowing that Kale has no more flash. I don't know, I mean, he expended flash, but then, that was a bit too frisky of a move by Alesso.
Yeah.
Now he stayed just for the tunnel, and he got, he was caught out of position once again by Kaito and Leo.
Yeah. I'm also guessing medyo communication error. Yung parang mga dating, hold that thought. Silence si Chanel gets knocked off. Leo gets
nice
cast right there just to displace Leo near the turret. Just a couple of more hits, but no, tatamaan niya na yung cannon minion right there. Ano nga ba yung sinasabi ko? Yung ano, could be miscommunication na parang dating na, oh sige, i-bait mo lang sila, nandyan na ako, parating na ako. Parang,
pero medyo malayo-layo pa si Rachel.
Kaya sobrang yun, layo. Di ba may mga ganun na moments tayo na palag.
Diba? palag-palag. Halfway through the map. Palag, pre, palag.
Yeah, may mga ganun
na moments. Don't be that guy.
yeah, guys. That's from Professor Kyra Deer.
Yeah. So yeah, maybe probably a com error miscommunication.
Oh! Wow! Good
buckshot in the face!
Yeah, sobrang painful. But nahilang papunta kay Akeno-san itong Alistar. But meanwhile, in the top lane, nagtitrade itong dalawa. Tumakbo pabalik si Cookie. Wala lang. Gusto niya lang daw bungguin yon.
Yeah, the devastating charge actually hurts a lot.
Yeah. Both of them are quite low. Pero obviously, nanalo dun yata sa trade
si Hecarim. Yeah, Hecarim is on top right now in that trade.
Yes. Oh, and, Trinity wow. Force pala tong gagawin ni ano, no?
Yeah, at hindi sila, no one opted for a ignite, I mean, a smite top.
Yeah.
Both of them are wearing ignite. And kanina, kani-kanina nasira na ni Kale, ni Alesso, yung mid lane na first tier turret ng STI. And kahit na lumamang na si Kaito dun sa trade nila kanina with that kill granted to him dun sa gank ni Rek'Sai. You know, still, Alesso knew what he needed to do. He just destroyed the turret, and now that gives that frees up the map for TUP to roam better, having no mid turret to, you know, counter to contest the fact that they can, you know, go towards the blue and the red side of the map of STI.
Yeah, that's true.
And actually, he can now freely roam if he, you know, if he wants to, and I think that's what he wants to do right now.
Yeah, maybe bot lane perhaps.
Yeah. He can also actually gank top lane since, you know, Fizz has no flash.
Oh yeah.
And actually meron na siya nung kanyang Nashor's Tooth, which is the one of the core items for an AP Kale.
Well, I actually build Kale differently.
Well, what do you build?
Actually, Kale? Go Lich Bane.
Oh, Lich Bane. So you're more of a
burst
yeah. rather than the sustained damage.
The sustained, yeah.
I see.
I go.
So after you go the after you use Q.
Yeah.
And then
it hurts.
Yeah.
That's why I. What's my favorite? Parang hindi ako makita yung ganun na build.
Yeah,
people just
actually,
still go the Nashor's thing.
Yeah.
Pero it really pays off. Once you like snowball, it's really so hard to shut you down.
Yeah, but I think the goal for a Nashor's Tooth is, you know, the split
stacks.
Push and the stacks. Yeah, exactly.
But yeah.
Yeah, so you have a super fast wave clear.
Uh-huh.
And you know, you can still you still dish out a lot of damage coming from that passive.
Yes.
And looks like STI picking up the mid lane, however they get spotted right here by this ward. And you know, in terms of farming, it's Akalux and Ashley almost having equal amounts of farm right here.
Yeah.
No, it's just Ashley leading by 100. 100, no, 10, 10.
Wow,
10, it's
10. 100.
That's too much at this point.
Yeah, 15 minutes to the game. Medyo safe, very, very safe laning phase itong dalawang bottom lane duo, no?
Yeah, I mean, not much action coming in. A few trades, but, you know, no one really commits that hard to get that kill. Kasi, you know, Graves is quite a tanky AD carry, and Vayne is a very mobile AD carry. And in terms of early game pressure, Graves dishes out more pressure to Vayne than Vayne to Graves.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and Vayne needs those items to be able to, you know, to snowball and actually carry the team in the late game.
Yeah.
But in the early game, you need you know, so much skill. You need to be skill capped in order for you to use Vayne effectively.
That's true.
Yeah, so medyo mahihirapan talaga si Vayne dito early game.
Yeah.
It's like a gang in the top side of the map.
Oh, Gosu Mikane. Wait a moment. Also, the shadows. And here comes Alesso for the backup. And Cookie will get the kill. That was an easy gank from TUP.
Yeah, and it opens up the mid lane for Kaito, though, to push out this turret right here. But Grog is actually making his way to that mid lane.
Oh, body slam doesn't hit. But look at them, Cookie and Alesso.
Quite awkward for Leo if he decides to go in, but he decides to opt out of that one because he'd definitely die if he tries to go in on Hecarim and the Kale with an intervention to boot. And with that, KSH actually wants to trade this one right here. A dragon for a top tier one turret. And
Wow, it's actually open. Look at that. Two teleports will come up from top, and Red Team SCI gets the dragon. Here comes Leo for the back up. Aqualung super low. He will be the first one to fall. The triple knock up. SCI is obviously on top of this clash. They all flash in for the kill. That'll be a double kill for the Vayne after everything that's happened. Alesso was not present at all.
That was a beautiful unburrow coming from Leo right there. Three man unburrow knock up. Yeah. Knock up. Yeah, three man unburrow and yeah. Knock up there. And it provided the leeway for Cho'Gath to hit another Rupture.
Yeah,
and they never landed the ground. And they got a dragon. They got lots of kills in that one, and they got a dragon. But, you know, in terms of the gold... All right, now it's a 1k goldie because of that.
Oh! Look at that intervention just to mitigate all the damage coming in from the three members of SCI. That doesn't matter. Kakainin lang siya ng Cho'Gath. Kaito is on a rampage.
Yeah, and that actually the feast. You know, Kayle doesn't really have that much HP. She can survive fights because of the intervention. But without the intervention, no, a feast is just would take probably 33% of her HP. That's that much because Kayle doesn't really have a good, you know, HP base.
No,
because she's you know, a mage, a kind of mage that I don't know what
she's like, a utility mage.
Utility that packs a punch, maybe.
Yeah, the utility that packs a punch because you're there for the stacks with your teammates.
Yeah, so maybe a utility DPS.
Yeah,
something.
Utility DPS, sustain DPS.
Yeah, sustain. Mm. Yeah, actually, plus movement speed, you know.
Yeah, I like Kayle.
That's why, you know, there was a time in Memorial that Kayle had been used as a support.
Yeah, I actually did Kayle support.
Yeah, then. Yeah. And actually, a few champions are like that can be used as a support before. Like Nidalee actually was used, you know, some main na uso yung support Nidalee for, you know, I think that was last year.
Actually, pinaka annoying sa akin dati na duo before was the Caitlyn and Nidalee.
Yeah, the attack speed increase coming from the heal.
Heal and the pokes.
Yeah, the pokes as well. Yeah.
I really and the zoning ng ginagawa ni Nidalee sa brush, kasi lagi siya doon naglalurk.
Yeah,
which
yeah.
Is normal. Yeah, pero now that's I think that's over. The era of that is over. And we see Nidalee, Vira na actually, but still we can see her in the jungle.
Yeah. And looking at the item build, actually this is a peculiar build coming from KSH Ashley, building double lifesteal with that Blade of the Ruin. No, I mean Bloodthirster plus, you know, going for a Blade of the Ruin King. And this is quite unusual because as a Vayne with a Bloodthirster, you'd want to go for a Phantom Dancer next. But she's building double lifesteal right now. So I think she's gonna rely on the attack speed coming from the Blade of the Ruin King without the additional movement speed.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah, it's an interesting build, but you know, I think it would be more optimal still to go for a Phantom Dancer next.
Yeah.
Or probably a Yongmu's Ghostblade.
Oh,
Korean Vayne build. Yeah.
I'm not really sure kung bakit. You think it's for survivability? Oh. Yeah, it's just too far. They tried something there. Right now, people are pinging from TUP dito sa baba.
Yeah, and looks like people are actually making their way. Aquilus getting caught out there.
Oh, nakatayo lang siya. Konti na lang. At nahulog at namatay na pala si Graves. And right now, Ashley is taking free. And no, namatay na ang kanyang support. He will get exhausted. And here comes the Alistar. Alesso, super painful as well. Intervention just to remove the damage from the Vayne. He sucks in first. Ay, hindi. Medyo healthy pa siya. That'll be a double kill for the kill.
Yeah, and looks like they're willing to trade TUP. Right now, STI gaining an advantage in the top side of the map, having only Cookie to defend that turret right here.
Wow, look at the damage. Onslaught of Shadows will not be able to do anything. Ang sakit-sakit na ng Cho'Gath.
Yeah, the damage coming from that feast immediately erased Hecarim on that map. Cookie wanted to defend that turret. However, you know, the damage coming from unavailable in Kaito is just too much for him to handle.
Yeah, sobra. I mean, look at the KDA on the Cho'Gath. 5-1-4. Tapos medyo malaki-laki na si, ano no, si Kaito.
Yeah, nakabangon agad siya after that, you know, level 1 early gank coming from Ray Chanel. And he played these cards right. And actually, Ray Chanel didn't actually go to mid after that one to respond during the ganks of Leo.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so, no, Leo actually having also a good KDA right now. 3-0-5. 8 out of 11 kills, he was there to participate in those. And he actually he got a Skirmisher Saber plus a Cinderhulk upgrade. Huh. Oh, Akena's in trouble right here. Burned the flash, actually.
Natakot ako kasi parang nasa gitna na siya ng TUP.
Yeah, like, dude.
Dude, what are we supposed to do now?
Why am I here?
Wow, in a moment, Aquilux actually losing the trade against Leo. Leo's pretty tanky right now.
Yeah, with that, you know, the Sightstone Cinder Health combination. Plus, the reduced damage coming from the when you get smited by
the
challenging smite, yeah. So, Aquilux didn't actually deal that much damage to Leo right there.
Pero ang ganda ng ano, no? Ng KDA ni Leo. Parang ang linis lagi ng ganks niya.
Yeah.
That means.
Yeah, it's he's doing a good job right now in terms of ganking and participating in those kills. And sometimes yung bot lane lang ng KSH, no? Being too aggressive kanina like that. Well, it was an opportunity present in itself. Aquilux was just standing there by the turret.
Oh, yeah, right.
And but the frisky play coming from Nautilus din, no? He tried to use the depth charge kahit na medyo malayo-layo pa itong si Aquilux. And they know that Aquilux has a dash.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's a quite risky play coming in from here. And it looks like both teams are actually making their way into the Dragon right now. TUP has an advantage because they're in the Dragon pits, but what would KHLH do?
Wow, look at that. Knock off Alessa. Their primary target is Alessa right now. And everyone from STI is joining people in the pit. Napier si Ashley. Dragon is still alive. Aquilux actually in the backline. Gusto niya makipag-damage, pero hindi siya nakaka-join. And right now, nag-flash si Leo just for everybody.
Oh.
Everybody's leaving the pit. Masyadong delikado, sabi nila. That's a 3-4-0 exchange. The fight is not over. Available, unavailable actually, is he landing some hits onto the Alistar. Actually, that'll be an ace.
That would be clear ace for STI right here, aiming to go for this turret right there. But I think they ought to go to Baron right now after taking this one.
Yeah, maybe they want the turret after.
Maybe take the inhibitor. I think they could take actually this one because Vayne actually has, you know, much damage right now because of the Bloodthirster and the Blade of the Ruined King. They'll be taking this one down, but they won't be able to take the inhibitor because members of TUP. But no, they're still going for it right now.
They want to stay. Unless he's trying to zone them out with a Righteous Fury. And Cookie just wants to charge in, but he gets pulled back by STI. Rampage na po si Ashley. At mukhang masisira nila ang inhibitor.
Oh,
oh my god. Alistar just knocks Ashley down. And Aquilux, hindi na kailangan pala yung collateral damage. It will be enough. Akeno-san will spider his way out. Mukhang double kill na itong si Kale. And that is a 2-for-1 exchange in favor of TUP.
Yeah, I think what TUP needs to do right now is take Baron. Because with that inhibitor gone, and the minions actually are quite far away from their base, I think they ought to trade objectives. If they won't be able to take this one right here, then there's absolutely no counter to what STI did to their inhibitor.
Oh yes. Oh,
but you know, they're quite in danger because Leia is still here, can smite Gragas, but Gragas managed to outsmite him earlier with the dragon.
Oh, ang sakit! Also out of shadows.
Oh, that hurts!
Also Kaito. Alesso is still ignited. Actually, hindi na. Andito na si Fizz. And Cookie gets the ultimate. Nice intervention. Will he be able to last long? Cookie just wants to run away now. Probably, they get the Baron just to distract the members of STI.
Oh, nice dodge!
Nice mechanics from Unavailable. I bet he is still on the chase for this. Kasi may Baron sila. We need to eliminate these people. Na meron Baron, they're still on the chase. Here comes Leo.
Oh.
At sila naka great body slam. At mahuhuli atan nila itong cow. Natulak po si Leo dito sa Aquilux.
Oh, nice.
Be enough. The exhaust is there onto the Fizz at the moment. Pero wala lang mana si Aquilux. Rampage na si Unavailable. Tinulak ulit siya ng cow. And they're still on the chase. But the minions, look at the minions from SDI nandun na sa gitna. And here comes the Vayne with the final hour. We'll probably just kite down Chanel effortlessly. And people, oh my god, all over the map. May advantage ng SDI.
That was an over frisky play coming from Cookie. Did not actually require him to go deep, that deep in the jungle of STI, but then he still went in for it. And you know, with that, they mitigated the Baron advantage that they were supposed to have. With that Baron advantage, they could have, you know, turtled harder because of the inhibitor. They could have waited for the inhibitor to go get back in and probably wait for a STI misplay and,
yes,
you know, turn the tables around. But with that frisky play coming from Cookie, That just destroyed that opportunity of the Baron. The Baron advantage that they had.
Exactly. And look at that. Si Alistar lang ang meron Baron buff. And he's not actually the best, like, split pusher or...
Yeah, I wouldn't count on it, man.
Yeah. Not the best. And sayang, no?
Uh-oh.
Sayang.
Yeah, so, you know, napakalakas na talaga din bumawas nitong si Unavailable with that Triforce. And super tanky niya pa with that Randuin's Omen. And without Kayle, who's the primary magic damage dealer, you know, Graves would really have a hard time against the Fizz because of the Fizz's passive, first and foremost, plus the armor and the HP from the Randuin's Omen. And Graves can't defeat Fizz in a, you know, DPS battle.
Oh wow, Dredge Line misses, but everyone from SCI and dito sa baba and concentrating. Wow, look at the overkill of the Graves and all the ultimates in the world with the knock-up pa, grabe. Galit na galit.
Yeah. So, you know, it's just SDI looking to push here in the bottom side right here, waiting for the minions in the middle lane to make their way into the Nexus turrets of TUP.
Yeah.
Oh. And KZ actually in trouble.
Wow, ang ganda ng cast and the slow from Alesso. Right now, they're trying to peel off the members of SDI. Their primary target right now is the Cho'Gath. He will get slowed and gets ignited. Righteous Glory activated. Ganda ng knock-up, but that will be a shutdown for Alesso.
But that, you know, it was TUP. They're gonna be in trouble because Fizz is split, pushing up top.
Oh, they have to go back. They have to go back quick. Grabe, sobrang bukas na yung base ng TUP at the moment.
Yeah, but then, yeah, Fizz wasn't able to, you know, destroy the turret and clear those waves fast enough.
Yeah, but there were minions in the middle that were already not hammering down, but they're damaging the turret already dito sa the Nexus turrets pala kanina.
Yeah.
So, you have to be careful in these prolonged team fights that they're having. I mean, although may advantage sila, makakawala naman sila ng turret.
If you look at the items, you know, Kayle actually has a Lich Bane now.
I'm so happy.
Yeah, so it's a combination of being a burst, relying so much on the normal attacks of Kayle, you know.
Yeah.
It's just dealing damage with the passive and the E ability,
yes,
plus the additional coming from the Q. And the Lich Bane as well increases the burst potential, aside from the fact that she has a DOT.
Yes, yes. Oh, I'm so happy. Lich Bane. Actually, after Lich Bane, I either go for a Void Staff or a Rabadon's.
Yeah, probably. Because Kayle greatly benefits from a Rabadon's because, you know, the heal.
The heal.
Yeah, and the damage plus. So I think she's going to go for actually a Zhonya's Hourglass, which is actually a good pickup, you know.
It's like a double safety for you.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
for your teammates. Like, you can use the intervention. Yeah. Oh, hold that thought. Alistar might get caught up. Righteous Glory flashes away just for safety.
Yeah, that's actually a good flash coming from Alistar. Didn't wait for him to get knocked up. So, you know, just to prevent. Oh, Alesso in trouble here.
Here, intervention used. All of the shadows just to try. And here comes the Zhonya's teleport will come up from top. Aqualox in the back line. What is he doing right now? Nanakot na yun si Alesso. Cookie is trying to damage the people there kasi hindi siya pinapansin right now. Look at Kaito. He's down, but unstoppable na yun si Unavailable. Cookie is trying to run away, doing his best. You are a horse, but Fizz is just too slippery and it's too sticky for you. And right now, tinulok ulit siya ng Cal at the moment, but that is a 4-for-1 exchange in favor of SCI. They're creeping slowly into
the base. Yeah, I think they ought to take the game. They can actually take, if not the game, at least one or two Nexus turrets with that 4-for-1 exchange in their favor.
Yeah.
But the minion wave is actually quite far, so I'm not sure what they could make happen, or they, if they want to, they could like tank the turret here, but Akena-san is not really that tanky.
Yeah, wow.
So I don't think they can do it, but
really?
You know, yeah, the minion wave actually is there, so they can actually push, but you know,
seconds.
Yeah, responding time of the members of TUP is you know, they're alive now.
Alive, yes
so,
they are.
Yeah, Baron's almost up, 1:20 on the clock.
Yeah, nobody has vision of the area yet.
Yeah, because you know all their focus earlier was in the dragon area. Yeah, so you know they placed down wards over there.
Yep, and Alesso with wow, I like the build actually with the Fuhrer enchant on the base.
Yeah, yeah.
That's really great.
Yeah, Fuhrer is actually like Phage.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So parang per hit, naga-increase yung attack speed mo. I mean movement speed mo.
Movement speed
yeah,
mo.
To catch up. And if Alesso actually weren't didn't get caught dun sa push na yun, they might have had a chance in that engage.
Yeah, they need.
Yeah, kasi napaprock agad si Alesso ng ano eh.
Ng intervention.
Tapos sabay pindot ng zone niya. Yes. Tapos flash.
wala siya masyado na contribute
doon. Yeah.
Puro defensive lang ginawa niya.
Yeah, kailangan ma-peel yung mga members ng STI for her.
Yeah.
For her to be effective. Kasi if Kayle won't be able to normal hit, then wala masyado siyang matutulong with the queue.
Exactly. Very, very, maganda nang nagagawa talaga ng stacks, especially dun sa mga medyo tanky.
Yeah.
Diba?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I really like Kale's kit dito. Pero, look at STI. They're, sobrang controlled na nila yung map. Wala na silang pakialam. Tinitake na nila lahat kung anong meron yung TUP as of this moment.
Yeah, and this is actually good kasi that's what you ought to do when you're ahead, really ahead of the other team. No, take objectives, take whatever you can, deprive them of their resources. Mm-hmm. So, you know, kahit na mag-ano sila, kahit na mag-turtle sila, if they don't have the resources to farm, yeah, then, you know, the turtle is gonna be useless.
Oo nga. And, di naman, nagpiping ulit itong STI. Mukhang gusto nila dito naman sa bottom lane. Let's do this methodically, sabi nila. Pero Baron is up, though.
Yeah, Baron is up. But, you know, I don't think anyone, or probably STI would be going for that Baron. But seeing that inhibitor-wise, the mid lane is destroyed and they're just waiting for it to push up to the Nexus turrets, they would be taking down this bottom lane. So it would be a, like a two-pronged attack.
Yeah.
So from the mid and the bottom side.
At hindi nila na-defend. Medyo okay sana yung wave fear ni Kale, pero... Okay.
Yeah, she needs to hit.
Yeah.
But, you know, with the threat of KSH members, exactly, she won't be able to do so.
Yun nga, nakakatakot. Ang dami nilang pang-close gappers and pang-hila pa. And they're probably gonna take the Baron.
Yeah, they would be taking Baron right here.
No content. Ang laki ni Cho'Gath, nakakatakot. Yeah. Oh my God. With the Elixir of Iron Man. Iron Man? Okay,
Elixir
that
of
was
Iron
unintentional,
Man.
But it was fun. Anyway, yeah, they're taking the Dragon without any contest whatsoever. Looks like they're gonna try and do something. Itong TUP, here comes the horse, here comes the rest of the members of TUP. Chanel will eat the shark, but right now, Kale is in a safe position. Pumasok siya, landing a couple of hits, unavailable. Ang target niya ay si Aqualox. Will they get the knock-up onto him? Yes, they do. And si Ashley taking free hits dito kay Chanel. Gets knocked up by the Alistar. Nagzuzonis na ngayon si Alessa. Cho'Gath ang laki, very healthy as of this moment. And Alessa will fall because of the Vayne. Naka-Guardian Angel pa yan. Guardian Angel. And even with the Arc Light Vayne, it's so pretty and cute. Cutie is the only person left to defend the base. And I don't think he can. The timers are just too long.
Yeah,
still
but,
chasing.
Yeah.
It's gonna be an ace.
Yeah, so but still, Kuki is like 10 seconds away. Will he be able to do something to defend this one?
He doesn't have his ultimate though.
Yeah, Graves also 10 seconds. But yeah, I think they won't be able to do something here.
Yeah.
Just, you know, STI actually taking this game 35 minutes into it. 14-31 kill score, a 10k gold lead, a victory for STI.
Yeah, very dominating performance. But still, TUP put up a really good fight,
yeah,
defending their base.
Yeah, there was a mistake though in that last engage. I saw Kale putting an intervention to Gragas. It was a bit too late because he could have like placed it to
Graves
which
uh-huh,
needed all the interventions that she could get.
Yeah.
Because he got dived in by the Rek'Sai. Rek'Sai was just too outpositioned also because everyone was zoned by Cookie.
Yeah.
And in the backside in the Baron pits. And yeah, so looking at the stats right here, top placer, top earner here is Ashley, 11-3-4 with 15.4k. gold.
Wow.
And a double lifesteal build, a Blade of the Ruined King plus a Bloodthirster and a Phantom Dancer and a Guardian Angel. Yes. And but still, commendable effort coming from TUP. A few misplays just, you know, took that game away from them.
Yeah.
And you really need to take care of those misplays kasi one misplay can actually cost you the game, lalo na kung late,
yeah,
game misplay siya.
Totoo yan, totoo yan.
And you need to maximize yung abilities, or you need to know when to place your abilities. Yung nga pinag-usapan natin kanina,
yeah,
di ba? Would you place it early just to prevent CCs and
the
burst damage?
Uh-huh.
Or would you place it as a clutch ulti? And at that time, hindi niya nalagyan ng clutch ulti si Graves, which,
yeah,
definitely they needed that one.
Yeah, super. Kasi yun yung main damage dealer niya,
yeah,
in,
yeah,
the Graves.
Yeah. So that was TUP versus STI with STI Kingdom Sports Hub coming up on top. Uh-huh. And yeah, don't go away, guys. We still have 3 more games. So, yeah, can we get the schedule here?
Yeah.
So, the next game would be University of the Philippines Cebu,
yeah,
versus Victims of Love, Central Philippine University. So, we're going outside of Manila right now.
Yeah, yeah, we are.
Yeah, so Cebu versus Iloilo right here. And yeah, so don't go away. We'd like to reintroduce ourselves. My name is Professor Skyru, and with me is
GS Riku.
And we'll be right back.
Want more from your prepaid promo? Introducing the new Smart Prepaid Unli Call and Text 30 Plus, the best daily Unli Call.